At this moment, it is with great honor and privilege to introduce a remarkable individual who exemplifies dedication, perseverance, and compassion, qualities that make a great firefighter and even a greater person. He was born on August 22, 1972, married, and was blessed with 4 children. He is a Bachelor of Science in Nursing graduate from Liceo de Cagayan University, and earned his Master of Public Administration at Medina College. He has consistently demonstrated a profound dedication to public service. He entered the fire service in June 1996 and had his mandatory training such as Public Safety Basic Recruit Course and Fire Arson Investigation and Inspection Course. In October 2010, he then made his way into becoming a commissioned officer through a lateral entry. He was designated to different positions in the Bureau of Fire Protection. He became the acting station commander of Station 6 of Guagan Fire Station, Municipal Fire Marshal of Salay Fire Station, Station Commander of Station 1 Guagan Fire Station, Nazareth Fire Station, and Acting City Fire Marshal of Tangub City Fire Station. After that, he was given a bigger role. He became the Acting Provincial Fire Marshal of the Province of Camiti. With over 28 years of experience in public service, he has been instrumental in the different contributions of the Bureau, and he initiated the proposal for the land donation of Binangan Fire Station, initiated and lobbied the Barangay Council of Nazareth to provide funds for the beautification and renovation of male and drag quarters, and successfully implemented the OLP in 20 barangays of Tangub City Fire Station as part of the Bureau's Directive for Massive Fire Safety Education and Prevention Campaign. In addition, under his leadership, his office was able to accomplish and surpass the whole year target of activities that the higher office had directed to Mumbai. With regards to the conduct of fire safety inspection, fire code fees collection, and conduct of lectures, seminars, and fire drills, to name a few. He has not only given great contributions, but has also been recognized by different awards for his exceptional service, diligence, and commitment in all of the Bureau's programs and activities. Without further ado, please join me in welcoming our Chief Information and Education Speaker, no other than Fire Chief Inspector Willie F. Tan Jr. Sir, a round of applause to you.
Thank you, Madam MC, for your kind our zone director, to our assistant general director of administration, senior superintendent, to the human staff, to other PLP officers of the region, regional office, to the United Commission officer, good morning. It is my honor and my privilege that I am here to speak with you about something that is every day and daily that we have, we always experience in our daily activity. Especially that when our limitations, especially physical and financial, is being challenged. What is this emotional feeling of tension or this feeling of emotional and physical tension that is being questioned because of unpleasant events and sometimes it also involves our physiologic or biologic functioning profile? What do you call all of these unpleasant events in our life? These are stress. So if these stress and stressors persistently and excessive, na magbalik-balik sa atuwang pan or naman sa amin na especially if we are challenged with our limitations, physically, financially, and emotionally. It results to what? The feeling of tension. To the point that it can make us angry or it can increase our heartbeat. Na tayong mahimungan din yung maayos. So what I call about this is all because of stress. One is anxiety. No? So, increase anxiety because of this stress will consistently and persistently magbalik-balik. And then, our limitation is being challenged and we cannot do anything about it. And it will also to cause to a feeling of loss or worry. And in some ways, I'm a feeling of loss or emotional loss or worry. Mabati na to. We call this depression. No? So about 73% of our 73% of depression affects our duties and responsibilities. Kung getting depression, if this depression will not be addressed, it affects our capacity to perform our duties and responsibilities. Are you agree with that?
Yes.
You all agree? Yes. But because of our coping mechanism and strategies that we have and the experiences in our life, the experiences during our panabaho, this excessive and persistent anxiety, the challenge because of the coping mechanism that we have, we can ma control. And sometimes, and others, tolerance of the real tolerance of the person, hindi na niya makaya, and that will cause to another problem. With the causes, kung hindi na niya makaya sa ilang magulo at sa ilang mga pag-imanisan and other strategies, umuwi mo na siya ang major depressive disorder or disease. And hindi siya ma-address immediately, and that will cause to a psychosis. Okay? So, but sa akong mga level of tolerance, in general, or generic lang siya na mild depression. Manan ako ang kaya na ako sa bubangon, kaya na ito sa bubangon. And all of us accept na every day we suffer or we experience depression. Are you agree? Diba? So pagmatala na ito, kapag-wait na, if you realize or recognize that you already suffering in mild depression, nanotice ba din na? So inside family, sa mga marriage, na ngayon ang anak, pag nakagandaan, sa iyo noon, it could be a depression na, labi na o mali, challenge na nakuha ang physical, or wala tayong financially, or wala tayong mas malo. Diba? So, that is signs of depression na, only it's fine. But because we have some coping mechanism or nung katapamaan, we address, na-address na ito at mga depression, mild depression. And also sometimes depression also caused by social. And what are these social events or unpleasant events? Na ikaw na ito social. But because social, it involves our interpersonal relationship with others. Number one, sa atong asana, sa atong family. Diba? We have family partners, mga couple. Sa mga married, sa mga couple, hindi mo wala na-based on sex. And because it's
pagkakasabot ulit natin. Ayan natin mga strategy. Natin yung mga pamaagi na we can address our context in the family. Lahat ng mga relatives,
no matter it's the first baby, say, but experience that.
Panginoon. Before pa lang sa panu, before pa lang siya ng panganak. Dala na ng pastor. Pangalan ng pagpanganak. At ito na din ito po. How can I survive or kaya ba natin ng panganak or pag-deliver sa baby? And kung yung mga panganak natin, kaya ba natin sa buhay po? Kaya ba natin sa panganak? Those are just a question na ang inyong pag-ibigan sa panganak na isang binapasol ay kaya ba din. But because of the support group, isa itong mga support group from friends, from relatives, especially ang pagiging mother, kay kapalunan sila na close experience ka. And those person and those mothers na hindi na kaya ang bati sa postpartum group, muna siyang mamago siya, effects of the changes of hormones upon delivery of mother, of postpartum group. Okay? Ang dili ko na matuloy ang katuwang challenge sa iyo, physical challenge o mental challenge, sometimes may story na ito ay open. Clinical na rin siya, depression na this need of treatment, need of psychological counseling o kung support mo sa atuwang sa family and friends. So, those are mga major ko na ito siya. Tawag na sa amin. Severe na depression po ng personal depression. And also, pag ako kung other than postpartum blues na because of social or unpleasant events, yung mga traumatic events, PTSD, ako yung mga syndrome na nangyayat ako na sa yung dinamuwi either through accident or loss of a self-person or loved one, no? Sa pagkawala, mahimong siyang traumatic experience sa atuwang pinagawin na kung hindi na matuloy, inventory ko psychosis or even depression. And even sa atong, hindi sa atong younger stage pa, sa atong bata, sa mga bata, o sa atong, makatingin mo sa atuwang pinagawin mga anak. Psychosocial development, isa kaila Harrison, Jordan Harrison, psychosocial development. 18 months old, 0 to 18 months old, nasa ikaw na trust versus mistrust. Yan ang di-develop sa itong mga baby na nasabatay ninyo ang baby or kung mga 18 months old, hindi na siya mag-uro. Other person, isa lang. Ito lang niya, mama or mother, ito na siya mag-trust. Because naman siya ang ginagawa. If this trust versus mistrust na-interference, na-aban siya ay may sabong na ma-develop, 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 ma-develop. Ako ang anatong pagdapo o pag-develop ay puso siya ay sa akong bata. Hindi siya mag-trust na gila siya sa tao o ma-develop ang mistrust. Kaya sa tao kung sa iyo pagiging mo, hindi siya mag-trust sa inyong walang confidence, walang hindi ma-develop sa iya ang inyong so, the middle ages or middle age, nakalitaw na general committee and sa kung tanong na labi na sa mga 40 years old up ang iyong sexual development na is na nasa 60 congressman, sa pinabaho, sa aking family, achievement, tapos sa dolinon, muna na ilang taon na sa ano mga binigay na aktual. At first intervals, na yung ma-interfere o na yung na ay ma-develop o na ay binigay mo ba, isa po na siya mag-cross sa progression. No? Kaya na ito yung mga pangatulit na ato na yung ma-achieve. Hindi na ito umang-ubang. Especially sa pagkakas ng mga children sa ito ang problema. Promotion, ito pa. Sa ito yung mga hindi-ipan sa ito ang problema na ito. At hindi na ito direct sa makuha. And that will affect us. And it will cause depression. No? So, it's person can always be addressed immediately if we only recognize it and address it immediately. Ang importante is ma-recognize nato immediately ang person. So, kung hindi nato sa ma-recognize and somebody na nag-suffer of depression and then magsigisaw, balik-balik sa isahan ng depression and mga psychics, then it may give it or manage some another problem. It could be big problem at that. So that is why self-awareness and recognition, immediate recognition of the person suffering for this immortality mode. Kita, that to recognize immediately our self-limitation physically and mentally. And for us to be strong and to be stable, that one personalized person. Let's be proactive in communication. Try to put pag natin mga depression at problema, it's atong diretso ba ka kung siya i-dedicate na diretso ang issue niya. It's time to keep it in ourselves and look for ways that we can do or we can solve the problem. Umagin na itong buhati. Nandiyo na ito to the kind na ilagay na ito kaya. Ang metabo is, kaya lang ito, yung ang pagyago na space na ito. It's either to fight or to fight. Do you mean by that? Either to fight the problem, accept the problem, whatever problem na nagtabo sa inyo, accept. Kung nakay taxes, nakay tutulungan sa inyo ang nagtabo ng problema, you accept. Inyong taxes, o inyong time. Ayaw pagpaka inyo niya mag-inso or just to na inyo ang matabunan ng inyo ang cover up in Manila, it's more braver to be coward than to face the truth. Rather than to stay alive or to cover up. In the time, living siya maayos or living siya perform to be close to another problem. You know? It's more braver to be a coward and to say, to accept what is the truth. So, even that recognize immediately, or hindi na ito ma-communicate. Computer na sa kubang sa computer.
give a break,
facilita to mga mata. And for us also to exercise and tension sa itong lawas, sa itong muscles. Ito, and do some physical exercise. That's it. And look far away. Look for a color green para ang atong mga mata or atong eye muscle or itong reduce ang iyong eye strain. Look something far, green, and then stretching for us to be relaxed and adjust some tension. And to organize.
Let's have those persons.
ang mga kalangan, no? And then, avoid discrimination. And with that, I am the professor of living attitude, the athlete provincial fire marshal of the PSP. Thank you for your time and thank you for inviting me as your guest speaker. Thank you and good day.
Thank you for that very informative message, sir. It is indeed a very timely reminder to all of us. At this juncture, may we call in our regional director, Fire Chief Superintendent Almagran Abakahin, ma'am, to award the medalya ng papuri to our speaker. Citation reads, medalya ng papuri is hereby conferred to Fire Chief Inspector Willy M. Tan Jr., Acting Provincial Fire Marshal Camigin, for his insightful contribution and commendable performance as the troop information and education speaker during the traditional Monday flag raising ceremony held on August 12, 2024 at the BFP Regional Office 10. Such display of dedication and commitment served to inspire and motivate others, contributing to the successful achievement of the BFP's mandates and programs, thereby worthy of recognition and emulation. Given this 12th day of August 2024, at the Office of the Regional Director, BFP 10, Gumamela Extension, Carmen, Cagayan de Oro City. Signed, Almagran Abakahin, MMPA, MPSA, Fire Chief Superintendent, DSC, BFP Regional Director. A round of applause, please. And now, let us now sing with honor and pride the BFP hymn. Thank you, and once again, good morning.